Welcome to the Words to Empower television broadcast, featuring Frank and Jackie Stewart, pastor and first lady of the Acts Ministries. And now, Frank and Jackie Stewart.
Merry Christmas and Happy New Year. Welcome to the Words to Empower broadcast. We thank you for joining us on this wonderful, beautiful Christmas day.
Merry Christmas, First Lady.
Merry Christmas, Pastor Stewart. God bless you.
Amen.
We're so glad to be here, and we're glad that you're joining us on Christmas Day.
Amen.
Happy Christmas. Merry Christmas.
And it's a blessing to be able to be on Christmas Day to celebrate his birth. We know it wasn't today, and we know it wasn't probably this time of the year, but it's the holiday, not a holy day. It's a holiday, and family and friends, and every day we should be able to celebrate him. If he's been born inside of you, brothers and sisters, have you been born again? Mm-hmm. Born of the water, born of the Spirit, have you been born again? If you're born again, he's on the inside of you. And First Lady, I want to say you are looking very, very
Christmassy.
Christmassy with your white and your red and looking good. I thank God for that. So we're talking about Christmas.
The story of Christmas.
My favorite time of the year. And going into a new year, 2023, he's just so good to us.
Yes, he is.
We haven't done anything to deserve this. It is because of his grace. If you can earn it, then it won't be grace.
Right.
So we thank God for the grace. We didn't ask him to come into the world. He came into the world because he loved us. He had to come. Mm-hmm. When nothing else
would help, love lifted us.
He had to come. So we talked about last week in Genesis chapter 3, the first 24 verses. Mm-hmm. We start talking about that. We didn't finish, but we got to that verse 15 where the Lord told the serpent that the seed of the woman, mm-hmm. that's Jesus. That's one of his titles. Mm-hmm. So here in Genesis, he is prophesied about, it is prophesied about his coming mm-hmm. because of sin. Mm-hmm. One sin. I don't think we kind of speed up a little bit. I don't think we really take time to think about it. One single act of sin, mm-hmm. Jesus had to die.
Yes.
That is a holy God.
Wow.
And just imagine, we have no chance without Jesus. Jesus right. is it. Without Jesus, we have no mm-hmm. chance without him. You know, we talk about without spot, wrinkle, blemish, any such thing. And sometimes people actually thought they were talking about them. No, that's talking about the body of Christ. You will never be without that. You will never, none of us will ever reach that goal. But Jesus, the body of Christ, no spot, no wrinkle, no blemish. So you know what, First Lady? Mm-hmm. When I stand before God, I'm going to tell God I'm with him. I'm with him. I'm with Jesus. Because see, when you're born again, when he looks at you, he sees Jesus. The body of Christ. I'm happy today for Jesus. He came into his world.
Yes.
Created the world. World made by him, John said. Mm-hmm. And the world knew him not.
Yes.
John said it was the incarnation. John said that the word was made flesh.
Yes.
But we got to verse 15, First Lady. What? Here in Genesis chapter 3, and it's talking about why he had to come. Mm-hmm. Why he had to come.
Yes.
There was nothing else that could help.
Right.
No
right.
other man, nothing. No angel, nothing. And the thing we have to understand from a theological point of view, Jesus had to come because without the shedding of blood, there's no remission of sin.
Right.
And God is a spirit.
Mm-hmm. Yes, he is.
God is a spirit. He doesn't have blood.
Right.
God is right. spirit. He mm-hmm. doesn't have blood.
Right.
Now, the only way that we could be saved was by the shedding of blood. Mm-hmm. So it looked like the devil done won. There's nobody qualified. Mm-hmm. You got to have blood. God is a spirit. He doesn't have blood. Mm-hmm. But love.
Found a way.
It found a way.
Jesus found a way. God had a way.
Yes, yes,
and
yes.
I love it because as soon as Adam and Eve sinned in the Garden of Eden, Jesus didn't come right then.
Right.
It was not time. He had to give us so that we could understand the spiritual aspect of who we are. He had to give us some natural examples and some types and some shadows and some things that would point us to Christ. And so in the garden, when they sewed those fig leaves together, those makeshift coverings that they made for them didn't last. They were not sufficient to cover Adam and Eve. So God became the first designer clothing line, where he created clothing and coats for both Adam and Eve to wear. And so he had to kill an animal. That animal's blood had to be sacrificed just so they could be covered.
Yes.
So their nakedness would not show. So that they could continue with life and not be exposed. And so the Lord let us see that he not only provided the covering that Adam and Eve needed in the garden, he also, by coming into his own world, was going to provide the covering that you and I needed for our sins.
Yes.
And so because they sinned, everyone born after them was born in sin.
In sin.
So that's why we understand, okay, so if the sin is in the blood, the sin is in the bloodline, they pass it on. Everybody came and originated from Adam and Eve, no matter what ethnicity, no matter what continent you live on, no matter what color of your skin, we all originated from Adam. Adam was the first. He was the first Adam.
Yes.
So now we need a second Adam.
The last Adam.
Yes. That's going to redeem us. But he has to come into his own world. He has to take on flesh. He has to have blood. Because without the shedding of blood, can't shed his blood if he doesn't have blood.
Amen.
So the Lord God wrapped him, robed himself up in flesh, being born of the Virgin Mary. In the person of Jesus Christ, he came into his own world so that you and I could celebrate his birth. We
Amen.
Could celebrate this time of the year. We could give glory and honor to God and sing like the angels that came forth to the shepherds and said, glory to God in the highest.
Yes.
Peace
yes.
on earth,
yes.
goodwill toward men, because now we have a Savior that has been born. We don't have to
Christ
die in sin. We don't have to rot and go to a devil's hell. We don't have to be on our way to eternal damnation and eternal destruction. We now have a way out.
Yes.
Because of Jesus.
Yes, because, you know, he put those, we see here they put those cherubim, that cherubim, and the Bible talks about that cherubim in the Garden of Eden, the cherubim of flame and sword, to turn every way so you couldn't get back to the tree of life.
Right, right.
But Jesus, he could. Yeah, he could exactly, exactly. That he got cut and he had to bleed, he got bruised, but he went and he opened it back up and he welcomes us to the tree of life. We can now spend eternity with him forever.
Yes, yes.
Eternity. You gotta realize
that's
that.
Christmas.
And the thing we look at, First Lady, that we have to understand, there's so many messages here. But one of the messages is worth mentioning. Man sinned, and it was going to take a man to get us out of sin. Because you got to have the shedding of the blood.
Yes.
Adam had authority. When Satan is tempting Jesus in the book of Luke chapter 4, he says, this has been given to me. Mm-hmm. Adam gave Satan the authority. When they sinned and obeyed him, gave him authority. So now it takes another man. An angel couldn't come. God couldn't come. It had to be a man. Had a man put us in it. Now, this last Adam, mm-hmm. he's going to redeem us out of it, out of sin.
Yes,
so, and he's
yes,
going to
yes.
give us the right to the tree of life.
Yes.
We're so blessed. Jesus came.
Yes.
Jesus came, and he suffered, he bled, he died. He did all that for us.
Yes, and this Christmas season, this Christmas day, we should put more emphasis on Christ and his birth than on the gifts under the tree, than on the turkey and ham that's on the table, than the movies and different things and that's happening, the shopping and the hustle and the
Absolutely.
Bustle of the day
Absolutely.
And the commercialism. We must put all that aside to focus and home in on Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God who came into the world. That little babe that was born in Bethlehem, he's no longer in the manger in Bethlehem, but we celebrate the beginning. His beginning on earth as we know it.
Yes.
That was not the beginning of God, because we know John says in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was it in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. We understand that Jesus is the reason
for that, the season.
Yes, that we celebrate today,
yes.
That we celebrate every year, that we celebrate. Don't ever put more emphasis on Frosty, the snowman, than we do on Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Never put more emphasis on Santa and his reindeer than we do on Jesus Christ. Never put more emphasis on the Grinch that stole Christmas than the Christ of Christmas.
Amen.
So when we understand our hope, and when we understand our life, and we understand everything that Jesus did, especially coming into his own world so that you and I could be saved, we have a reason to celebrate. We
Amen.
Have a reason to give God praise. We have a reason to glorify our God, because he came into his own world.
Came into his own world. The world rejected him. He was the creator, and the world received him not, but he came in and he died for us. So on this 25th day of December, mm-hmm. that we set aside to just commemorate and to celebrate this incredible event, he came into the world. Mm-hmm. Now, you know, sometimes, I was going to say, some people get upset when I say this, but that's all right, I'm still going to say it. You think about it, he had a choice whether to come or not. Mm-hmm. You think about that.
Yeah.
I mean, because if you don't have a choice, it can't be love.
Mm-hmm. Right. And if you find yourself disappointed, unhappy, even angry, upset, or mad because you didn't get that certain gift,
say it again, first
that
lady.
Certain say gift
again.
That you thought was coming up under the
yes.
tree from a certain individual,
it's not your birthday.
Just be thankful
yes.
to God that
yes.
Jesus came.
Absolutely.
Jesus is the best gift.
The best gift.
He's the best thing that's ever happened to us. And so when you can praise God for Jesus, when you can praise God for Jesus being in your life, and if he's not in your life, today is the best day. The day that you hear his voice, harden not your heart. Today is your day of salvation. Jesus is the best thing that's ever happened to us.
We'll be right back after these messages, because we want you to be fired up and excited about the Christ child. And because today is Christmas, don't think it ends today. Christmas is not over after the 25th day of December. God bless you. Greetings in the wonderful name of Jesus Christ. We are so excited that God has blessed us to be in the month of December and the last month of the year. And brothers and sisters, we're asking you to partner with us as you do every year. Your partnership is greatly appreciated. So this is the end of the year. So we're asking all of you that can to partner with us for that $100 love offering in the month of December. Amen. So we can close out some things and get ready for 2023. We thank you in advance. Understand that when you partnership with us, everything that we're doing, every person we're blessing, you are part of that, and you are going to be rewarded like we are. God bless you, and we thank you again for being a partner of the Acts Ministries. Thank you.
Merry Christmas and happy holidays to each and every one of you. From our family to yours, the Stewart family wishes you a blessed Christmas season.
And we're hoping that this holiday season will be a tremendous blessing to you and your family, that this will be the season that will catapult your family into the family that you want it to be. Again, we say unto you, Merry Christmas and a happy holiday.
Welcome back to the Words to Empower broadcast. We are talking about the study of Christmas. Today is Christmas Day, and we're excited and we're delighted to celebrate it with you. And we thank you because God is opening up His Word unto us so that we can better celebrate Christmas when we know what we're celebrating, who we're celebrating, and why we're celebrating.
And you know, the Bible says in Isaiah 9:6, First Lady, for unto us a child is born,
unto
and a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulders, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father,
and the Prince of Peace.
So that's Him.
That's what He wants for us.
Yes, that's what He wants for us. What can we surrender? What can we give for all that He's given unto us? He gave His life. Mm-hmm. He came to save us. And the more we recognize how much we needed saving, you know, we can't stress that enough. If we don't get the point that we were lost,
right,
and that what happened, that's why we went back to the book of Genesis, so we can kind of paint a picture for you.
Mm-hmm.
So we all can see that we was lost in sin,
mm-hmm,
and no way out,
right,
no way out,
mm-hmm,
no way out. And it looked like all was lost. It looked like all was doomed. It looked like Satan had won. It looked like he was going to be in charge of everything. But God found a way. God became a man.
Mm-hmm.
Now the enemy didn't realize that. He thought he didn't realize that the omnipotent,
he didn't see that coming.
The omnipotent, omniscient, omnipresent God,
mm-hmm,
wrapped Himself,
mm-hmm,
in flesh,
mm-hmm,
came through the womb of a virgin.
Yes.
He's a God that will hide Himself.
And he's the only one who has been born of a virgin Mary.
That's it.
Now, you used to hear WWJD, What Would Jesus Do?
Right.
I was driving down the street the other day, and I looked at the bumper sticker on the car in front of me, and it said, What Would Buddha Do?
Oh, my goodness.
And I was thinking, Lord have mercy. They don't have anything, so they're trying to grab a hold to the truth, to God, to Jesus Christ, to try to make it seem like the other false gods in the world today have some of the similarities or the same power that Jesus has. But no one, nowhere, ever in heaven above or in earth beneath, under the earth, no one is like Jesus.
None.
Jesus is the only eternal, everlasting Father.
Yes.
He is the Prince of Peace.
Yes.
He gives us not peace as the world gives us, because that's temporary, that's shallow, that's on and off, that's here today and gone tomorrow. Jesus says, I give you the very peace of God that surpasses your very own understanding. You will be wondering, why am I so calm? Why am I so peaceful? Why? Because it's the peace of God that He gives unto us, peace that flows like a river. He's the Prince of Peace.
Yes.
And so if you ever need peace, Jesus is the reason for this. He gives us peace even in the midst of turmoil, even in the midst of adversity, even in the midst of war, even in the midst of turmoil, even in the midst of death, even in the midst, He's able to calm us and give us the peace of God. And it was prophesied by Isaiah.
Yes.
This son that was going to be born, he will be called the Mighty God.
Yes.
He's the God-man.
He is the God-man.
Who would have ever known that Mary's baby was her God?
Yeah.
Mary's little baby that she rocked in her arms would one day be carrying her.
Yeah, the very one that she was rocking in her arms is going to be the very one that walks on water, the very one that created everything. Before he was born, he was already the creator. Man. That's what the Bible says. He came into the world. He was in the world made by him. So mm-hmm. he was the creator before he even came into this world. And he came into this world to save us. Mm-hmm. Now, you know, would you have done that? Would you have left heaven to come to earth to save those that would reject you, that would put nails in your hand, stick a spear in your side, reject? You know, we look at the cross, but we don't realize that all his life he was rejected. Mm-hmm. I mean, his whole ministry, he was rejected, even his family, even his brothers. We don't realize that that suffering didn't start on the cross. Mm-mm. The rejection, they called the very creator, they called him Beelzebub, they called him the prince of devils. Mm-hmm. His life of suffering, you know, the Bible says he's a man of sorrow
and acquainted with grief.
Think about that. A man of sorrow, acquainted with grief. That's the creator. He came into the world. You know, you think about that. He had a choice, because if it's not a choice, it's not of love. He had a choice to come into this world. And he chose to come. No man
taketh my life.
You said, no, wait a minute. Let's get it straight. Nobody taketh my life. What happens?
I have the power to lay it down, and I have the power to pick it up again.
He gave it. Mm-hmm. He gave it.
He laid down his life for his friends.
See, yeah. And Peter thought that he had to help.
Even while we were yet his enemies, he loved us. He loved us out of our mess. He loved us out of our sins. He loved us out of our shame. And he loved us unto life.
Wow.
Eternal, new life, abundant life, life everlasting. And so this Christmas day, when you sing the Christmas carols, and hopefully you have gone and you know, there's so many songs now that we call Christmas songs that have absolutely nothing to do with Christ. And I'm not saying that they're sin. What I'm saying is the focus should be on the true meaning of Christmas. Because if we allow our kids to sing the Jingle Bells and the Santa in the Sleigh and Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, and they know all these songs, but if you ask them to sing Away in a Manger or to sing O Holy Night or O Little Town of Bethlehem, and they know no words to the real meaning of Christmas. Yeah. It's our responsibility as parents, as grandparents, as adults, as men and women
That's
of God, as brothers and sisters.
That's on us.
We have to pour into our kids so that they will know the true meaning of Christmas.
Because if we don't, if we let a generation pass without teaching them and instructing them, then just think about that, the generation after that. And that's what is happening now. That is what's going on now, that in our busyness, and look, during this time of the year, people are so busy. Mm-hmm. I mean, the stores and people going, getting gifts is about, you know, giving gifts and receiving gifts and all of that. And we forget about the meaning. Mm-hmm. Christ.
Yes, even if you're driving in your car, listen to the Christmas song. If you're driving, listen to the Christmas story. Play the scriptures in Matthew and Luke of the story of Jesus. Play it so that you can ask your kids and your children and your grandchildren questions as you're just traveling down the road. Have them cut the tablet off for a minute and spend some family time together in the car talking about the real meaning of Christmas,
yes,
so that they will be knowledgeable of the God that loves them and wants to save them, and that is their God as well. So that it's not only a bonding time, it's a enlightening time, it's a joyful time, it's a peaceful time, it's a wonderful time to spend with your friends, family, and loved ones talking about the joy of Christmas, the joy that the Lord gives. Just through the birth of Jesus Christ himself coming into his own world.
He came into his world.
This time of year where we celebrate, even though, like we said, this is not the day that the actual date of his birth.
Right.
But this is just the time that we recognize and we
celebrate.
Makes
you feel like singing, tell you that.
Yes.
Yes.
And when you quoted and you were saying the lyrics to Mary, Did You Know That Your Baby Boy Would One Day Walk on Water? Mary, did you know? You know, the songs just start coming back. And, you know, just to be able to hear and to reminisce and to, when you start thinking about the greatness of God.
We should be able to. Yeah, we should be able to worship Him like that.
Yes, worship. It provokes worship.
We shouldn't just have one song we sing every Christmas, and that's all that we have is Emmanuel. You know, and we know all this other stuff, but we've limited just because our time and our effort, we haven't given it to Him and to worship the great I Am.
Sing some songs, some Christmas songs with them, and if they don't know them, play them until they learn them. Let's learn this song. Let's sing them.
And because that is ministry, ministry to the children, ministry just about Christ and learning how to do that. It's so very important that we learn how to do that and we lift Him up, because if we don't, then we're going to lose a generation. And then that will arise.
A generation that knows not the Lord.
Oh, wow. They'll know Saint Nick. They'll know Saint Nicholas and Christmas Bell and all this kind of stuff and Santa Claus, and they'll even know Rudolph.
Who's coming to town, but who really came to the world, who came to the earth. That's what we need to be learning about, not who came to town, but who came to earth, and that was Jesus Christ Himself. The everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace,
Amen.
The Son of God.
Father, in Jesus' name, we thank You for Your word. We thank You for this time of sharing. We pray, Lord God, that every listener that hear this word today, or that will hear this word, we pray for that born-again experience in their life. We pray that Christ will be born in them, the babe of Bethlehem will come into their life. Fill them with His Spirit, the Spirit of the living God, Father. We want that. We ask You for that. We want to experience like they did on the day of Pentecost, that wonderful infilling, and experience Christmas like we've never experienced it again before. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Thank you for joining us. We wish each and every one of you a
Merry Christmas.
And a Happy New Year.
New
we
Year.
Love you with the love of God.
Amen.
Enjoy your friends, family, and loved ones
today.
And until next week, we wish you God's blessings on today and every day. Have a blessed week.
Amen.
The Axe Ministries is located at 1423 Ingram in Conway and 1224 Franklin Street in North Little Rock. Call 501-329-2055 or go to axeministriesonline.org for more information.